tripping. Is this one thing that got me tripping? You did this one thing, you saw me feeling. Is this one thing you did? Oh.
Hello everybody, here I am again with a bit of an update. And look at this, this is the new fashion accessory of 2020. And you can actually make your own, as you can see. So this is in line with the artwork for Build My Mixtape. Yeah, so that's kind of nice, isn't it? So, but it stays on. actually, I'm not planning to do the entire recording like this. Let's just take it off. I just want to prove that I got one, yeah. just want to have a topic to talk about, and I always have something to talk about, and I want to tell you my favorite dream. Now, if you want me to wake up happy, then I spend the entire night lost in a record store. That is my favorite dream, and I do dream that very often. And for example, I'm living in the UK and I'm actually blessed with a handful of quite good record stores not too far away. So when I mean in about half an hour distance, I can see loads and loads of record stores. And actually in one town in Guildford, you've got three, which is amazing. You know, you got HMV, which is like your regular main store where we actually got a very wide range of new releases, and then you've got two other stores, and it is more the independent record stores where you can actually create a personal connection with the people behind the counter, like the one in Camberley and the one in Farnham. Now, about Farnham, that is a record store that's called 101 Collectors Records, and it's got a lovely view from the outside. So I will just show you a picture of how that looks like. It looks brilliant, yeah. And inside you've got Andy, and you know what a dream that is to own your own record store. And especially I've got a picture of Andy in his store. I mean, you think about that. That is what dreams are made of. At least my dreams. And the last time that I actually visited Andy, I actually left with some very interesting records. So let me just show you what kind of records I bought. For example, you got this thing called Record Store Day. And there is this one release that I was really eager to get. And on Record Store Day, I was actually in Brighton. And I wasn't able to get my hands on it because there were only 500 made in the entire world. But then, to my surprise, weeks later in Farnham, I found it. Here it is. This record. This is absolutely brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. I've been playing it a lot this week and it is absolutely stunning. It is one of the best albums that I have right now. So, you know, that was a great find. So I was so happy. So the whole thing about me dreaming that I'm in record stores is that you actually find records you were actually looking for without actually looking for it. You know, the weird thing about growing up in the 70s, 80s and 90s is that you did not have internet. So if you want to get an album, or even before the CD, you have to get vinyl, yeah? There was no other choice. Or cassettes, of course. Also cassettes. But I, for instance, when I was in my teenage years, I had to cycle about half an hour to get to my nearest record store without knowing whether they actually had the stuff that I would like to get, yeah? The best thing is actually when you go into a record store, you're actually not searching for anything, but then you find a record you were actually were looking for. Now, a lot of women would have that same idea when they go shopping for clothes. You know, in the UK, you've got this chain called TK Maxx. In the United States, it's a TJ Maxx. It's the same company, basically. And you don't know what you're going to get, so you go into that store and then either you're lucky or you're not lucky, yeah? So what women have with the TK Maxx experience, that is what I have with record stores. Makes me actually wonder why there are not that many women involved in all these Facebook groups about hi-fi equipment, for example. It's a very male culture, and I actually don't understand why. Why would 50% of the world population, or maybe it is even 51% to be quite honest, you know, the women in this world, why do they not seem to be so keen to be in these groups? I have no idea. If you've got an explanation, then let me know, because I would really love to get some insight in that. Now, the other record that I got when I visited 101 Collectors Records is, surprisingly, something that I was eyeing for a while. Not this particular record, but the band, the Brian Setzer Orchestra. Now, this is one of the guys from the Stray Cats. The Stray Cats had a few big hits in the early 80s. And this is a Christmas album, yeah? And unbelievable that it is also on a very nice vinyl as well. The color vinyl is great. So to show you this, now, this is beautiful. Look at that. Oh, I'm a sucker for this kind of stuff, yeah? So, but this is lovely. But this is like a good, old decent rock and roll with a hint of rockabilly maybe, but it is absolutely fantastic. So I would imagine that if you see him live, you're going to have a great night. Yeah, so if you're into all kinds of music, you know, then check this guy out, because it is really cool. And this is now becoming one of my favorite Christmas albums. Yeah, so two great albums during one visit of a record store, when I actually was not planning to buy anything. That's the real thing, of course. You go into a record store and say, would I buy something? You have the idea that you wouldn't. And then you leave with two great records. Actually, I bought a third record, and it's right there. Let me just get this very quickly. While I'm getting myself organized, let me tell you about my Build My Mixtape initiative. I want you to give me recommendations based on a theme, and the first mixtape will have the theme, artist name or song title that contains the word one. And here, three of the recommendations I have already received. This, I will get this out of the sleeve. This was kind of a surprise to me. This is a Simply Red record, and this looks very old. You know, when you look at this, it's still got the price on it, so you know how much I paid for it, whether or not you think that's worth it. You know, I was the one who bought it, so. It looks like a very old gramophone record. So when you look at this, you know, you look, this is a very old, authentic gramophone record, yeah? So, and this is 78 rotations per minute, yeah? 78 RPM. And you play that on those gramophones that you see over there, yeah? And so Simply Red made a record that looks very much like the old ones. And they got plenty of those as well. But then this, when you look at the record itself, they really made an effort to make it look like the old ones that I just shown you, yeah? And I don't know the quality of it, I haven't actually played it yet, but I will pretty soon. It is second hand, there's a lot of dust on it, so I probably need to clean it. Anyway, this is and when you look on the sleeve, there's a lot of fun that they've had when making this type of artwork. Yeah, this is absolutely fantastic. So when you get when you pause it and you really look at the sleeve, you see all kinds of fun stuff on it. So yeah, the reason why I bought this one is just because of the nostalgia feel with the old gramophone, and yeah, that they did some good with the artwork. So I actually bought it for that reason, without actually knowing it. I know the A side, if you don't know me by now, it's a great song, by the way, but the other ones I don't actually really know. So anyway, that is my visit to the record store. I don't know whether you have the same emotional bond with record stores like I have. If you do, let me know. Tell me about your experiences when you go to a record store, and what you look for, you know, because there's loads of things you can find in there. So is there something that you immediately are drawn towards? So I had a period that I was really looking for 12-inch maxi singles. I got loads of them stored over there, and maybe I will show a few of them, because a few are actually quite special. But maybe you go to 50s or 60s rock and roll, you know, or really in the psychedelic 70s, you know, or the electronic 80s, yeah? Or the house 90s. Let me know. So you can get in contact with me in, well, mainly three different ways. Even though I'm on Instagram and I'm on Twitter, if you search for Build My Mixtape. You can also find me on Facebook, and there I've got a page, and I'm quite active on that one, so have a look. Obviously I'm on YouTube, because you're watching this on YouTube. Leave comments, and if you leave a comment, I will talk about it. Yeah. And the third one is a podcast, and that is on anchor.fm. So if you are into podcasting and you want to hear some more stuff about the feedback that I get, and I normally use the feedback in the podcast itself, then my God, you know, you're going to be lucky. There's a very interesting second episode that I published last Friday, where Aaron de la Montaña was talking about the philosophy behind the mixtape, and that is actually a particular type of art form. It is really interesting, the feedback that he has given me, and I give my first reaction on that. And so I hope you're enjoying this channel. I hope you're going to enjoy my Facebook page and also my podcast, and I hope to see you next time.